Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to this tutorial series on some awesome extensions. And today we are going to talk about a UI view extension that can merge the elements of that UI view. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just show you what we are going to build out today with the help of this testing extensions fund. This is the completed project. Go ahead and take a look at the link down below in the description to see the starter project. Now, here we have a really awesome image from an Unsplash author. Collected this image from the site unsplash.com, and this is the author of that image. And when we are going to take a look at the code, you will see that this is a UI image view with this image, and we have a UI label with this text. Now I want to save all of this into a UI image, and then I'm going to present it down here. This is also a UI image view, but first of all, we want to merge all of this. So we are just going to click on this. And there you go, we have merged this. Now, it doesn't really seem that anything has changed, but as you can see, and you will see in the code, this is a simple UI image, and this is a UI image, and on top of it is a UI label. So let's take a look at how we can achieve this. Okay, and let's just close the testing project and take a look at the view controller. Now this is a really dummy name for this view controller, but yeah, we are going to create an extension for a UI view. So here we have our image view and our label with the text and an image, a dummy image as an original, and our button and our output image view. All of them are laid out with the help of tiny constraints, and here we can handle the button tabbed. Okay, now let's just first of all create our extension, and this could lead to some typos, so I'm just going to simply paste that in and run through what basically it does. If it's available as of iOS 10, we are going to use this one, these lines of code. If not, we are going to do that the old way. So we are going to create a renderer, that is a UI graphics image renderer, and we are going to render the image on the renderer context, that is the layers renderer. And so you don't really need to understand all of this. What is important is that the bounds is the bounds of our UI view. An earlier version of that would be to create a UI graphics get current context and then get the contents frame size. Now we are not going to get the bounds, the frame size, and then we begin an image context and here we end it, and inside there we get the renderer and we create our image. And then we guard let unwrap that image because it's a CG image, and we return that as a UI image. And of course, we create that UI image with the help of the CG image initializer. Yeah, it's kind of weird, but yeah, it does the job, and you don't really have to care about that. So now we have our extensions as image. Now let's go back and first of all, let's create our image. So let image equals, and I believe the image is in the image view and as image. Now again, we are adding the label to the image view. Now whatever is on that image view, on the bounds of that image view, will be processed. And what we want to have now, after we do that, is basically add that onto the output image view. So output image view image equals image. And as you can see, this is an optional. And again, this extension is optional too, so we can safely add that in there. So without further ado, let's just start and test this out. Okay. Oh, I just forgot that we need to go to the app delegate and change the example type to be view. So let's build and run again, and this should work fine. Okay, I'm back here. So let's tap on merge into image, and there you go. Simple as that, we have merged. And of course, you can add other images here and so on. I hope you enjoyed this video. Merging image views and so on, labels, UI text and so on into a simple UI image. If you did enjoy it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. And the next video will be about navigation, and we are going to create some awesome navigation extensions. So, as usual, I will see you in the next one.